Okay, I'll go ahead and call the common council meeting to order. It is 6:01 PM on Tuesday, May 10th, 2022. Let's stand and sit for the allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call, please.
Weagle.
Here.
Bargain.
Here.
Middleton.
Here.
Crowder.
Here.
Romano, absent.
Front of you are the minutes from our March 22nd meeting. Were there any changes or corrections? Hearing none, can I have a motion to approve?
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Jenny, seconded by Tad. Further discussion? All those in favor show by the usual sign. Jenny, Tad, and Dan approve. And Walt abstains. We don't have enough members for the April 12th minutes, so we will table those till the next meeting. Next up is Ordinance 2022-11. Do you have a motion to read by title only?
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Dan, seconded by Jenny. For the discussion, all those in favor show by the usual sign. It's unanimous of those present. Please read Ordinance 2022-11 by title only.
Ordinance 2022-11, an ordinance amending the zoning classification of certain property from the R3 multifamily residential district to the LB local business district.
As a reminder from last time, this is a change that went through Plan Commission, was approved, and this is for the property out on 50 East, right? Yeah. So, the former
Union Hall.
Yes. Yep. Any questions, comments, concerns about this ordinance? Reason? Okay, can I have a motion to approve Ordinance 2022-11 on second and final reading?
Second.
Motion by Jenny, seconded by Tad. Further discussion? All those in favor show by the usual sign. It is unanimous of those present. Next up is Ordinance Number 2022-12. Do I have a motion to read by title only?
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Walt, seconded by Tad. Further discussion? All those in favor show by the usual sign. It is unanimous of those present. Please read Ordinance Number 2022-12 by title only.
Ordinance 2022-12, vacation of property right-of-way.
Okay, Chip, I'm going to let you play ball here on the right-of-way.
This is the property. He came to Board of Works. He's came several times, Mr. Cofield, and he wants him three lots, and they have the parcel, so he's just wanting to combine them. He knows he has to go to the plat committee after he does all this.
Right.
So he's just right now on the first step of it.
So there is an alleyway currently, correct me if I'm wrong.
Yes.
There's an alleyway in between his two parcels that goes nowhere. It's not used as an alley. There's no continuance of the alley past the north-south alley that's behind him. So obviously he's trying to kind of put the parcels together, do something on it, let's say it that way. So.
Did he come to this meeting a while ago?
Yes. We had a little snack for it.
Okay. Any questions, comments, concerns? Okay, hearing none, can I have a motion to approve Ordinance Number 2022-12 on first reading?
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Jenny, seconded by Dan. Further discussion? All those in favor show by the usual sign. It is unanimous of those present. We'll move it to second reading at the next meeting. Okay, next up we have multiple DOT America tax abatement compliance with statement of benefits. So the first one we will take up is the real estate improvements, and this was from 2014. You can tell, obviously, you all know this since they've been presented multiple times, but they're obviously doing very well. They're overachieving in lots of different ways. So, any questions about this one? Okay. Say what?
So, we can get to the vote on all the examples.
We can if you would like. Is that the idea by the rest of the council? You're okay with doing that?
All their stuff.
Okay, let me go through each of them then. So the first one is real estate from 2014. The second one is personal property from 2014. That's on page 23. Third one is real estate from 2017, and that's on page 31. And personal property from 2017 is on page 38. Any questions, comments, concerns about those? Okay, hearing none, can I have a motion to find DOT America in compliance and grant an additional year of abatement for their 2014 real property, 2014 personal property, 2017 real property, and 2017 personal property tax abatement?
Okay.
Motion by Tad, seconded by Dan. Further discussion? All those in favor show the usual sign. It is unanimous of those present. Thank you for saving us a bunch of time there, Tad. Next up is ordinance 2022-13. Do I have a motion to read by title only?
So moved.
Second. Okay.
I'm sorry, did I say
there's a resolution number 2017-24.
24.
You just went down one.
No, that's the tax abatement.
Okay.
So ordinance 2022-13 is the actual ordinance for the golf cart UTV.
Got it. The next one right.
It's on page 45 of your package.
Oh, I see.
Okay. So I apologize. Jenny, did you motion that?
So moved.
And then Dan seconded? Okay. Further discussion? All those in favor, show by the usual sign. It is unanimous to those present. Please read ordinance number 2022-13 by title only. Sorry.
Ordinance 2022-13, an ordinance amending Chapter 73 of the City of Columbus City Code of Ordinances.
Marcia?
So, the ordinance committee has meant a great deal in general. But this has certainly been one of the discussion points, and the decision was not to do a separate UTV ordinance, but because we had a couple changes on golf carts, the thought was to combine them. So that's a little bit why I have that little bit at the top. But so there was slight changes to the golf cart ordinance from before, but obviously the UTV is all new, and so this is the result of our work. We tried to simplify it, make it a little bit more straightforward than what we had originally looked at, and so there it is.
And there is no charge on it.
UTV has no
for the permits. UTV.
Yes.
UTV has no permits. Golf carts do have permits. Gary, would you like to make any comments about this?
Well, the UTV has to be registered through the state of Indiana, so can't double dip on them anyways.
Yeah.
So we made the decision to not even inspect it because they have to comply with all the state laws anyways, the rules and regulations. So if we inspected it and put a permit on it, then we like pay a cost for the permit and we can't receive any revenue from it.
So the B&B has to inspect it?
They have to register it through the B&B.
Okay.
How often is that registration process done?
I think it's every 2 years or 3 years.
Okay. And so in the case where a UTV is going down Van Buren Street, West Van Buren, They are speeding or they're doing something. I don't know. I'm assuming these can go pretty fast. So they're speeding. You guys pull them over. But there's a process. You can actually look up their
registration
number. So it's the same thing like a car or anything like that.
They have to carry a registration in the vehicle.
Okay.
So in 30 seconds, what's the difference? What's a UTV?
It's also known as a side-by-side, kind of like the gators that we have, kind of like the layers.
It's got the doors on the side,
right.
And then there's two.
Okay, yeah.
Almost. I just wanted them.
It has to have four wheels, so it's not going to, the four wheels don't have.
Right. And it has to have seat belts, steering wheel.
Right.
So is there automatically a cage around it, or no?
Well, most of the side-by-sides of the gators just have the roll bar.
So roll bar?
So there is a definition.
Yeah.
I know. I just thought it was on.
It is on.
It is.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, we kind of beat that to death. Coming up with a true definition of UTV.
Because we didn't want four-wheelers and
right.
Motorcycles.
I know that. Let me start by saying this. I know that the committee has done a lot of work on this, and I appreciate the work that's been done. I'm assuming that there's at least somewhat of a standard that many other communities have taken to approve the same type of thing, correct?
Yeah.
Do we know what nearby communities, are nearby communities in that group? Or?
Yeah, we reviewed multiple.
We went through a lot of them.
Yeah.
We reviewed multiple. Surrounding area have these and kind of took a little bit from all to make our
own. Gotcha. Council members, other thoughts or opinions on the UTV golf course? Okay. Well, if there's nothing else then, I guess I'll ask for a motion. Is that a motion to approve?
Yes.
Yeah. 2022-13. Okay, I have a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Motion by Dan, seconded by Tad. Further discussion? Okay, all those in favor, show by the usual sign. It is unanimous of those present. We'll move it to second reading at the next meeting. Okay, next up is something we don't normally talk about. It's a utility rate decrease. There's a good reason for it. So let's have a motion to read ordinance number 2022-14 by title only.
Second.
Motion by Jenny, seconded by Dan. Further discussion? All those in favor, show by the usual sign. It's unanimous of those present. Please read ordinance number 2022-14 by title only. I'm just reading up of what this is elected.
Ordinance 2022-14, an ordinance amending the rates and charges for the City of Columbia City, Indiana Municipal Utility Electric.
Okay. Rosie? Yes, please.
Okay. So, the city, the utilities, the electric and the water, has to pay gross income tax on their sale of utilities, and which is 1.4% of our revenue. So, the legislature decided they wanted to do away with that. And the only way we could do it is if we went back and gave the customers a decrease. So what we're doing is giving the electric and the water rates a 1.4% decrease. Even though now we just increased it during this pay.
For electric.
Yeah,
for electric.
For electric. So now it's going to go back down 1.4%. Does that make sense?
So as a part of the passing of that law, we must state that because of you have the actual, hold on, I'll get there. So I make sure I say the specific language I'm supposed to say here. Archie just sent that to me today, and...
It might have been the first email, I think, you know, the second. I can't remember now.
Yeah. Apologize for...
So, are we reading this?
Yes.
And what did we get there?
And what if we didn't know we did it?
No, we don't have a choice. They said we must. And again, I mean, this is a pass-through, meaning that this is something where we collect it from the residents and pay it to the state. So effectively, we're not necessarily losing revenue. It's the state that's losing that tax revenue, if you will. So this is... I can't find it. Oh, there we go. So it is it's a repeal of the Indiana Utility Receipts Tax. It becomes effective July 1. And so the Indiana General Assembly wants the public to know that it is because of their legislation that this tax decrease or this tax decrease has occurred, and this repeal will impact their bills in a positive manner.
How much time did it spend to save a dollar?
I think it was a part of the overall comprehensive tax package that that your legislature passed this year. Gosh, that's frustrating. I cannot find what the bill number is.
21 cents.
Does it say it in the ordinance? Oh, yeah, 1,002. Yes, I'm sorry. The Indiana General Assembly had passed legislation, specifically Indiana House Bill 1002, that repeals the Indiana Utility Receipts Tax. Therefore, all residents that are utility customers will experience a decrease in their taxes because of the Indiana General Assembly. I should be good now, right, Marsha?
Yes.
I said what I was supposed to say.
And some.
So, what?
And some.
So... with that being said, any concerns about Ordinance 2022-14? Again, you don't have a say. We have to do this, but okay. Do I have a motion to approve on first reading?
So moved.
Motion by Jenny, second by Ted. Further discussion. All those in favor, show by the usual sign. It's unanimous of those present. The same goes for our water department. So can I have a motion to read Ordinance Number 2022-15 by title only?
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Jenny, seconded by Walt. Further discussion. All those in favor, show by the usual sign. It's unanimous of those present. Please read Ordinance Number 2022-15 by title only.
Ordinance 2022-15, an ordinance amending the rates charges for the City of Columbia City Municipal Water Utility.
This is a decrease in the water rates because of the repeal by the Indiana General Assembly, Indiana House Bill 1002, repealing the Indiana Utility Receipts Tax, having a direct impact on the residents, our utility customers. Do I have a motion to approve Ordinance Number 2022-15 on first reading?
So moved.
Motion by Jenny, seconded by Walt. Further discussion? All those in favor, show by the usual sign. It is unanimous of those present. Next up is Ordinance Number 2022-16. Do I have a motion to read by title only? Motion by Jenny, seconded by Dan. Further discussion. All those in favor, show by the usual sign. It is unanimous of those present. Please read Ordinance Number 2022-16 by title only.
Ordinance 2022-16, an ordinance enacting and adopting the supplement of the code of ordinances for the City of Columbia City, Indiana, and declaring an emergency.
This is your annual / biannual approval of effectively further codifying the ordinances that you have passed in the past. So this is to put it into our, it's to put it into the American Legal Publishing piece. So, questions about this? Hearing none, can I have a motion to approve Ordinance Number 2022-16 on first and final reading while declaring an emergency.
So moved.
Motion by Walt, seconded by Tad. Further discussion? All those in favor show by the usual sign. It is unanimous that those present. Department head reports. Chip, we're starting with you.
Yes. So Westgate's getting ready to start these at the end of this month. We finally got the deed to the property. First Friday is this Friday. I see everyone out there. Okiali this week got all the plants planted. I need to clean up the, we've got a growth of algae on the bricks. Bike racks should be, all be installed hopefully this week downtown. And Tad, I'm going to kind of cut in on your RBC.
Please do, Chip.
Now, with young gentleman, Jacob Hillebrand, that came and presented, and about dog waste. And so, since Mark will not take over Okiali Park, I left him two dog waste stations on the Blue Trail that he can empty. And so, we're going to put another one over here in Thomas Marshall Plaza and another one in Okiali. So, other than that, everything's going well.
Questions of Chip? Thank you. Terry?
We're in the process of pricing out and replacing them with all of the free Wi-Fi project is still moving along, but we're being slowed down because of the premise of two parts of the So part of the network is undone.
Questions of Terry? Thank you. Sean?
We did complete the removal of all the trees for the tree board with the cooperation of the street department, obviously. We're going to start bringing stumps and see what's growing and all that soon. I forgot in the council or the board meeting that Janice Daniel made it out to Westgate today and started. We did a project there last year where we buried a lot of underground utilities where she was. Attempting to get the yards all fixed last fall, but we had a monsoon, just like we had this spring. So she was finally able to get out there today and start fixing the yards out there for those customers. So with this utility receipts tax reduction, not only did they lose the 1.4%, but then the health insurance for our state legislators went up by 1.4% from patting themselves in the back and spraining shoulders. So good for them. But yeah, we're staying busy. We've got a change in poles. We have a whole pole out. We're getting replaced down through the middle of town, so hopefully we start getting material in for that. It's just like Terry and his Wi-Fi project. The material is difficult to get a hold of right now, so we really have to kind of stockpile when we can. So we're working on that. We received our financials for the month of today, and they're looking better. What you guys have done, what we've done with the rates has helped, trying to get us out of the negative. So, appreciate all your work.
Question to Sean.
Sean, just to want to acknowledge, you're going to have a hiring process.
We tried to hire last year. We were not successful. We had three applicants. Of those three, two of them qualified, one declined to be interviewed, the other one agreed to be interviewed, but didn't show up to his interview, so we moved ahead with hiring two high school students for the ICE program, or that program that you're calling it now. So they kind of filled that gap, but their school's year is ending, so they're going to be leaving us soon, so now we're looking to try to fill that spot again. With the luck, the police department had great luck with their current application process, so we're hoping people are out looking for work again and working, to get a decent job. So.
Questions? Okay, thank you. Gary?
Well, I attended the State and City this last Friday. What a wonderful job that the mayor did. And
thank you, Gary.
Thank you for that. Absolutely. You did a good job, so I did want to recognize you for that.
Thank you.
Officer Cook returned from firearms instructor training. As I was told the Board of Works, we had two could have two firearms instructors now that are, could retire at any day, so
it was great.
I'm glad to get a young guy in there and get him through that training, because it's pretty extensive training. We received 21 applications through the police department. I think that's double what we had last time in our hiring process. Testing starts May 21st. As Chip said, first Friday in farmers markets this weekend. We had a department meeting on May 2nd. I think went very well. We got a lot of, some things came out. Some guys got some things off their chest, so hopefully we can work on those things and work together. Dispatch, Megan is doing fabulous. She's been released solo. I said released at one meeting. She's on her own now, working shifts, so she's doing a good job. Rachel, we hired her. She brings 9 years of experience from K County. She isn't familiar with our Spillman because they have a different program over there, but she's really touching on quick for that. Her trainers and Shane are both very impressed, as I'm pleased with both of them. So they're doing a good job. Hopefully she'll be released by the end of this month. I have a department meeting on May 21st for dispatch, so I'm excited to do that. And I'll just update for Kelly. And when I visited the sewer repair down here on Oak, between Oak and Old Trail, they've completed the sewer repair. They did flowable fill today. It's like 8 inches deep right now. Tomorrow, that's going to cure overnight. Then tomorrow, this mid-block will come in and put the binder down, base, they call it, and then leave down about an inch or so, and then I'll come in Thursday morning and put the surface on top. So right now, they put the barricades close to the trench. They had open, so now the eastbound lane is passable, so they can, eastbound is open. So Thursday morning, Thursday afternoon, the whole road is open.
Question to Gary. Thank you. Mike.
During the Board of Works meeting, they approved a Works Made agreement with Donahue and Associates. So we're going to move forward with the design on the new Force Mains. And today I met with the Midwestern Engineers by the CSO 19. That's the end of the pipe is falling off, so we need to have that looked at and have some engineering done and have repairs made to that. On that note, the engineering cost for the Force Main project was originally came in at $94,100. When we interviewed all the companies, Mary, myself, and Chip, we sat down, we had six, we narrowed it down to three, interviewed those three companies, and then selected two at the end that were top two, and one project went to Donahue and Associates, and then this one we're going to turn over to Midwestern Engineers. And the ARP funds, $150,000 was set aside for that project. With it coming in at $85,100, that leaves a balance of $64,900 that I'd like to ask for council's approval to take that and move that money from the Force Main project over to CSO 19 project and use for the engineering of that.
So that's a formal request to basically take the balance of that $150,000 we had to move it over to a different project. Still same again to the, do you still have those pictures? It may be beneficial for them to see that. We don't know exactly what happened, but some of the pipe fell off of another piece of pipe. You'll be able to see it. I don't know how better way to describe it. But so his request obviously is to kind of look at repairing that and really trying to figure out how we can get that whole area in better shape, let's say it that way.
Yeah, to do some bank stabilization. They were having issues with the way it was designed originally as far as collecting samples. Our automatic sampler doesn't work because the velocity of the flow coming through is just way too fast. That is just pulling air. So we want to take that and move that structure out away from where the discharge is on the treatment facility to try to make that work better.
That's right up. Is it right outside the EQ tank, like at the on the riverbank?
Yeah.
Yeah. So it would be at the north end of the property, north-ish end of our wastewater treatment plant, down by the river.
So I just want to make sure I understand. So we had 150,000
that we appropriated in ARP. Yeah, for the force main project.
Okay, and that's left
and
over.
It ended up, and so the it came in at 84, right?
85.1, and they originally had it at 94.1. So they actually, when they went back and put the agreement here, they reduced their price by 9,000, which actually gives us
more room. So the difference between the 150 and the 85 is what he's requesting that be moved over to the bank stabilization type thing. So is the council approving of that?
Yeah, I
believe that we accept. Okay. That's fine. Okay, I have a motion by Tad to approve that request. And Dan seconds. Further discussion. All those favor show that you can sign. It's unanimous at this point. Anything else, Mike?
I talked about during the retreat the replacing the radios on the lift stations because they're outdated. That process has started. Donnie's come in. They've actually taken, visited all the sites, taken pictures, and put together what we need to do at each site. I have a feeling we're probably going to have to split that into two different, possibly three, to get everything done. I don't know what the cost is going to be yet, but they're also working with JK to put together packages for each one. So once we get all that, then I'll be able to see what that's going to be. But we're working on that. That's the big things. So, yep.
Questions? Thank you. Mark?
Kind of heavy with baseball and softball right now. On weekends, every day. Busy with games. Busy with concession stands. Andrew's doing a great job with the concession stands. We started striping parking lots today. And just so many of our stripes are doing that. So, we're doing that ourselves. And we striped soccer fields today. Trying to get the aquatic center ready to open May 22nd. You know, the real official opening day is May 29th. I'll tell you more about that here in a second. We're going to fill the pool Friday just to get the chemicals, try to get it balanced here in the next couple weeks. We've got volunteers coming this Friday from the high school to help set things out at the aquatic center. Pulling leads, trying to add more, just make it look nice, I guess. We had a lot of training this Saturday for lifeguards and that's staff pool. We're having a special opening May 22nd. It's from 3 to 6. You have to have one of these passes to get in, and we're using this as a training for our lifeguards. So if anybody's interested, I can pass these out if you want them. But you have to have passes to get in, 3 to 6, 3 of them. Mowing a lot, staying busy.
Question to Mark. Thank you. Marcia. Rosie. A couple things for your information. Tom will be back, I think, the 16th or so. He's been off for a while now. You may have noticed it, maybe not, but the volunteer firefighters are putting together a recruitment retention program for their firefighters to try to attract more volunteers. As I mentioned, the State of the City address, I think we have at least 16 openings right now in our volunteer department, and that's pretty consistent across the board when it comes to townships and others. So they're trying a new recruitment retention strategy that we'll use some videos, we'll use some marketing materials, things like that, to try to get the word out that, like, hey, you too can be a volunteer. And serve your community in that way. So, I know this is much surprise to everybody, but he says Engine 105 has the light on again. So, they're working on that as well. A couple things for your information again, Tad will talk about redevelopment, I'm assuming, but a lot of good things happening today. Met with Columbia City Connect. Just to kind of get an update on where they're at, what they're doing, good stuff's happening there. Obviously, they're excited about the first Friday event that's on the second Friday. So we got that happening this soon. Last night, the Utility Rate Advisory Board met, looked through the financials of our utilities, didn't have any formal action or anything. However, as mentioned in State and City, as well as in Patrick and other things, the Board of Works did approve a comprehensive rate plan that Baker Tilly will do to kind of give a kind of a map of where to go. And again, that's a really great way in which we can, instead of waiting to the last minute and slamming our customers, if you will, with a huge rate increase, instead of looking ahead at what costs we have coming up, what kind of projects need to be done, and then coming forward with some kind of strategy going forward with those rates. Whether it be you do nothing, we're in good shape, or whether we do, you know, a couple of cents or whatever it is, so that we kind of keep up with things. As you can guess, as you all know, prices on everything are not going down. So in any case, that study will start assuming like tomorrow or whenever we get them the information. The Westgate neighborhood, our final public meeting with phase one individuals is this coming Monday. And so we're, you know, this is kind of their last chance to ask any questions. The contractor will be there. We'll kind of run through the phasing and everything like that. So Westgate will be starting here when, Chip?
They're open last week.
Last week of May. And then budget meetings will begin next week in earnest. And then we'll get budget meetings set up with you all as well. But so that's loads of fun. I think that's all I have right now. Well,
I have nothing.
Dan.
Nothing.
Tad.
Well, it should be still a lot of fun.
Sorry. You can rehash them, though. I didn't go down the movie.
No, I was passing the bus. Now, RDC, we did, you know, Chip talked about the student film, Field Tech. Actually, it's a pretty cool thing. He's stepping up and, you know, doing that because we have had complaints about people not cleaning up for the dogs. And then we worked, we discussed the redevelopment of the Cardinal Green Elemental building. That site seems like the chemicals and everything are starting to work in most cases, and we're probably about a year out before we really do anything, but we're trying to just get some ideas and of how to use that property. And Chip is going to work on this, give us some ideas of not just that property, but that surrounding that little corridor of, you know, businesses and their rentals, and, you know, just so we can come up with a better idea of what we can do with that whole region as a whole and how we can develop that. Come up with some things, and then we'll process that information and see if we want to hire someone out to give us some more detail on this recording.
Thank you. Danny.
I have nothing.
Press. Nobody's in the audience, so we'll call the meeting adjourned. Thank you.